Hi, today I want to talk a little bit about resolvers. So what we see here is a Nissan Leaf motor that's been donated by New Electric from Annie Kloppenburg from the Netherlands. And we see here a so-called resolver to digital board that's been donated by Damien. So it's a pretty big board, and I thought maybe we have some free resources on our microcontroller and do the resolver handling on there. So I went on the internet, and first thing I looked for, how can you make a sine wave from a square wave? And that's what we see here. On the blue cable, we have a 4 kilohertz square wave. And that's just being low pass filtered by a three pole filter, and that comes out as a sine. And then that's being amplified by a cheap audio amplifier chip below that L cap here, and that goes all the way to the excitation connection of our resolver, and then it comes back. Same cable in here, and it's being low pass filtered some, and we can see the result of that on our analog discovery right here. So as I just touch, it's hard to spin it smoothly because it cocks so badly, but you can see how it sort of corresponds to the rotor position. And now there is a piece of software on the inverter that basically the task is A, to generate, let's see a good one. Okay, to generate the square wave, 4 kHz square wave, and then sample at the right moment. That's when the sine reaches its peak. Sample its amplitude, and then by using an arcus tangens function, determine the angle. So if we plot the angle, it looks jumpy, but so we have a jitter from 117.9 to 118.2. So it's like a jitter of 0.3 of a degree. And you can see when I spin the shaft how it actually tracks the movement quite nicely. Okay, so all I have to do now is come up with a meaningful way to control the motor, and then we have a very cheap way of interfacing resolvers and running synchronous motors. Thanks very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Check out the links to my Patreon page down in the description. Leave a like and all that. Bye bye.